Hi everyone! Today, I'm going to share with you how to submit MAPTU SSS Maternity Benefits Application online.
Kung bago lang kayo, please like and subscribe!
First, go to Google, then type member sss.gov.ph. And then, click the member. Sign in using your user ID and put your password. Select all the images with stairs and then click verify. Check I'm not a robot and then click submit. In your portal, click the e-services and then go to disbursement account enrollment module. So, dapat meron kayong bank account na nakapangalan sa inyo and then you need to make sure that it is active. Dito kasi ilalagay ng SSS ang maternity benefit na makukuha natin. So, select an enrollment option, bank ba yan or e-wallet, and then enter your bank account number and then confirm. So, select document type. Sa akin nilagay ko is validated deposit slip. And then, upload or choose a file. And then, attach supporting documents. So, validated slip dun sa akin. So, please take note na uploaded supporting documents must contain your account name, account number, and bank name. You choose a file that is readable and PDF or JPEG format. Maximum file is 1 MB. Also, don't forget to select a bank. Ayan, so dapat nakalagay dito yung bank account details and mobile number, sa'yo yun. And then, ikaw yung owner ng valid and active bank account. Once you're done, check the I agree that the information data is provided. Click the enrolled disbursement account. Your account will be submitted to SSS. Do you want to continue? Just click OK. At the bottom, you'll see your active disbursement account record with SSS. So once we're done with the bank details, go to e-services and then submit maternity benefit application. This is the MAT 2. The submit maternity notification is the MAT 1. So once done with the MAT 1, go to the MAT 2. Just click proceed if you're done with the important reminders. Ito nakalagay, filing date must be within the 10-year prescriptive period from date of delivery. Basta dun sa year, 4 digits yung numbers, like 2019-2019. Click also the number of pregnancy. So sa akin kasi twins, kaya dalawa yung nakalagay dyan. So for the required field, type of delivery, live childbirth. So it depends on you if you're a solo parent or with allocated leave credit. So, you need to click that. So, with me, voluntary kasi ako. So, wala akong ikiklik dun. And I'm not a solo parent. And then, click also the disbursement accounts and proceed. So, as you can see, sa estimated amount of benefit is 19,250 for voluntary. So, kung nagtatrabaho ka, baka mas malaki yung makuha nyo. So take note, estimated amount of benefits not yet final, you are eligible to maternity benefit based on the number of qualifying contributions. However, the date of payment of your qualifying contributions is subject for validation of SS. So yung mga naka-red na asterisk is required field, so you need to attach your file. So ang ihingi na lang po sa inyo is yung live birth certificate ng anak nyo. So you need to make sure that it is a PSA copy. So, just read the certification. Ayan po. And then, click the I certify and submit. This action will send the supplied information to SSS. Click OK. And then, it will notify you that you have successfully submitted your maternity benefit. And then, click OK. You will receive an email regarding this one. Just wait because your maternity benefit is being processed. And then, just go to your Gmail account. So, they will email you that you have successfully submitted your maternity benefit application. For my first attempt, they said, "We regret to inform you that your application has been rejected by SSS. Please take note of the transaction. date submitted, date rejected, and the reason, certificate of member's child is not duly registered with the local civil registrar or Philippine Statistics Authority or PSA. So with regards to that, you need to apply for Philippine Statistics Authority copy. So kung yung email nyo is same as mine, since yung sinend ko po is hindi PSA copy, so you need to apply for a PSA copy or NSO copy. Just go to Google and search for PSA helpline.ph. So ayan, 3 to 4 working days pag within Metro Manila, and mas mahaba siya kung outside Metro Manila. So you have 3 easy steps: request for a certificate, and then pay online or over the counter, and then wait for delivery. So click the Let's Get Started. Click nyo lang po yung birth, kung ano po yung kukunin nyo, and then check I accept. Just make sure to fill out all the information needed. So it says here that requester information, you need to present your valid government issued ID upon delivery in the address indicated. The courier will not release the PSA certificate to anyone but you. Before you proceed, you make sure that all your information is correct, and then click continue. So the amount due is 365 per copy. For payment options, you can choose GCash para mas convenient po. Pero marami po silang pamimilian. You can just check it. Which one do you want to use? It says here that your GCash payment was successful. So delivery reminders, basahin nyo lang din po yan. So kailangan kayo po talaga yung haharap dun sa courier, kasi kayo po yung nakapangalan together with your valid ID. They will not give it to anyone except you. So they have a contact number in case hindi po kayo po pwede. So kung anong availability nyo. So once your PSA certificate arrive, you can take a picture of it and then go to your portal again sa SSS. So just repeat the same process kung papaano mag-apply ng MATU. Once approved, ipapadala na lang nila sa inyo, sa inyong bank account, yung maternity benefit. Usually, maximum of 1 month naman daw po bago maipadala yung maternity benefit natin. So, antay-antay na lang din. Pinaka-max na yung 1 month. So, I hope nakatulong tong tutorial na ito.
And thank you for watching! Bye-bye!